the situation in Idlib, in the northwest of the country, was like becoming really dangerous. The army was like bombing most of the city, and they were pushing in the place where we were like documenting the rebel side. And this picture is like, for me it's important because that picture was taken in a park where like children used to play, people used to drink tea, and was converted into a graveyard because the army was like pushing so far inside the city that they couldn't do the proper burials in their cemetery. So Ahmed, the mole, the small boy, is crying next to the tomb of his father, Abdulaziz. And it was like really chaotic, really sad. We tried to make some, I tried to make some pictures. Ahmed, the camera guy, Ahmed Bahadou, he tried to make some video. And then the problem was to find that picture. The rumor was that the Syrian army was like, they could find your location with the sat phone signal. So if you stay a long time in one place, you are a target. So we were trying to find out the way of sending pictures out from Syria with that risk. And the incredible thing of that picture is that I was really frustrated of working in such a dangerous place, but not only that, not having we didn't have the opportunity to file the amount of picture we want to move like with freedom. And the next day I have a gap of like 10 minutes to check my emails, and I receive an email of Manucher and Santi and Rick that picture was published in the New York Times, Washington Post, and Wall Street Journal the same day. So for me, that was a really incredible story, for me, because it was so difficult that then when you see that picture or those pictures spread out in the media, that could tell the story, could sensibilize of what is going on in that country and what these people, these civilians, are suffering. So for me, it was really important to see that the work finally reached a big audience.